Let's start with antibiotic resistance. Most of you are probably familiar with that term. It occurs when bacteria are found to be resistant to the antibiotics that are meant to kill them. And that can be very dangerous, even deadly, if you happen to have these resistant bacteria.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this actually happened to Dr. Wieland, the founder of Creation Magazine. He wrote in an article in the magazine about the experience that he had with resistant bacteria. He says, after over 12 years as a medical practitioner, I suddenly found myself an avid consumer rather than a provider of medical care. Involved in a serious road accident in 1986, I spent many months in hospital, including weeks in an intensive care unit. While in intensive care, I became infected with one of the varieties of so-called super germs, which are the scourge of modern hospitals. These are strains of bacteria which are resistant to almost every, and in some cases every, type of antibiotic known to man.
He continues, several others in the same unit with me died as a result of infection by the same bacterial strain. The germs overwhelmed their immune system and invaded their bloodstream, untouched by the most expensive and sophisticated antibiotics available. This super germ problem is an increasingly serious concern in Western countries. It strikes precisely those hospitals which are more high-tech and handle more serious illnesses. Applying more disinfectant is not the answer. Some strains of germs have actually been found thriving in bottles of hospital disinfectant. The more antibacterial chemical weapons that are being used, the more bacteria are becoming resistant to them. The reality of increasing bacterial resistance seems at first to be an obvious example of onwards and upwards evolution, but the facts, when carefully examined, show otherwise.
Mm-hmm. Okay, he hinted here at the end that this antibiotic resistance is not evidence for evolution. Does that surprise you? Most people have heard through the media and the education system that antibiotic resistance is evidence for evolution. So let's look at why it isn't. Well, for starters, note that there are a number of different ways that these superbugs can become resistant to the antibiotics that are meant to kill them.
A superbug is, by definition, resistant to many different antibiotics. It may have become resistant to antibiotic A in one way, to antibiotic B in a completely different way, and to antibiotic C in another way. Mm-hmm. So if we look at all the known ways of resistance arising in a population of germs, let's see if any of them are uphill information-adding processes.
Yeah, okay, firstly, some germs already had the resistance. I mean, out of a million bacteria, if five already have a feature that makes them resistant to, say, penicillin, then soaking them in penicillin will kill all of them except for the five.
That's right. The body's natural defenses will often mop up such a small population before it can multiply and cause harm. So resistance won't become a problem. Mm-hmm. But if that doesn't happen and those five germs multiply, their offspring will also be resistant. And within a short time, there will be millions of germs resistant to penicillin.
Okay, a couple things to notice here. First, this is why multiple resistances to major antibiotics is more common in hospitals which treat more serious conditions. It's because these are the hospitals that will be using the sophisticated, expensive, heavy artillery antibiotics. So this sort of natural selection will happen more often.
And secondly, in this kind of instance, the information to resist the antibiotic was already there in the bacterial population. Mm-hmm. It didn't arise by itself or in response to the antibiotic. So this obviously is not evidence for evolution.